An illegal immigrant charged with homicide has been released and is out on the streets tonight because politicians in Denver have decided that keeping our country's borders open is a higher priority than protecting our citizens. Police say that Ivan Zamaripa Castaneda killed a truck driver in a hit and run. Federal law enforcement wanted him held in custody, but thanks to Denver's sanctuary city policies, authorities there refused. They did not hold him. They let him go. On Friday night, lawyer Paul Reyes came on this program and said that wasn't going to happen. The progressives in Denver were not trying to protect illegal immigrants at the expense of public safety. Watch this. Why wouldn't you, if you're the Denver Sheriff's Office, the second call them and say, you know, this guy's leaving at this hour, be waiting for him? Why wouldn't they do that? What's the answer? They're not going to get sued for that.
Because as ICE itself has said, they are issuing on a daily basis, a weekly basis, between 35 and 40,000 of these detainers.
No, I'm not talking about 35. I'm talking about this guy, the guy charged with homicide. Why wouldn't they do it in this specific case? Will Denver do that? Why wouldn't they?
The reason they did not was because, again, ICE did not make him a priority by failing to get the warrant for him. Because they did not get the
warrant,
the local law enforcement did not take it seriously.
They don't need a warrant.
The local law enforcement
does need a warrant.
Now you're
being disingenuous. They're not doing it because they don't care. That's the truth, and you know it. Well, he was, of course, being disingenuous. ICE asked the Denver Sheriff's Office for notice if Zamaripa Castaneda was going to be released, but deputies in Denver refused. After he posted a $25,000 bond, Zamaripa Castaneda was released at about 5:30 p.m. on Saturday evening. ICE was not notified for more than an hour, and by that time, he was gone. Zamaripa Castaneda is now on the loose. He's an immigrant fugitive. So a person is dead, and all the Democratic Party can think of is how to protect his killer from deportation? That's normal on the left now. In Oakland, California, federal authorities wanted to arrest drug dealers, child molesters, and gang members, but Mayor Libby Schaaf warned them so they could get away before the feds showed up. The press howled, and a woman called Perla Morales Luna had her arrest caught on camera. You've probably seen it online today. They suggested she'd been abducted from her family. It turns out she was wanted on human trafficking charges. That may not have made your Facebook feed. In Baltimore, meanwhile, one of the poorest cities in the country, officials cut city funding for streetlights and trash cans to plug a hole in the budget, and yet somehow the city found hundreds of thousands of dollars to pay lawyers to represent illegal aliens fighting federal law. In all cases, the message could not be clearer to the rest of us. Democrats are on the side of illegal aliens over hurting American citizens. They're not even pretending anymore. Jorge Ramos is a Univision anchor. He just wrote a book. It's called Stranger, The Challenge of a Latino Immigrant in the Trump Era. He joins us tonight. Jorge, thanks for coming on.
Tucker, great to be here again. Thank you.
Thank you so much, and congratulations on the book. And the book is partly about what American policies ought to be. We're talking about what America's policies ought to be on this show. And so in light of that, I want to ask you about a tweet that you just sent out, which I was amazed by. It was in Spanish, but here's what the tweet said. I got my voter credential to vote from the United States in the elections in Mexico on July 1st. Now I have to register and wait for my ballot by mail. It's an expensive and complicated process, but you have to do it. I thought you were an American.
I am Mexican and I am American. That's completely legal. And I wish I could give you an easier explanation on my identity, but that's exactly who I am. I was born in Mexico. I became a U.S. citizen, and that's why I have the chance to do that. And I feel very proud of being from Mexico and very proud from being from the United States.
But wait, when you became, there's nothing wrong with being from Mexico. I agree with that completely. What's wrong is that when you became a citizen, you took this following oath. This was a pledge. And you said you swore absolutely and entirely to renounce all allegiance to any foreign state you have ever been a citizen of. You took that oath, but you're voting in a foreign election? How does that, why are you doing that?
I'm voting in Mexico, and I'm voting here in the United States, and there's absolutely nothing wrong. Some countries allow that, and that's precisely why I have a U.S. passport, and I have a Mexican passport.
But there is
And by the way, I'm not the only one, and I think I can participate fully in the U.S. electorally, and I can do exactly the same thing with Mexico.
And the relationship between Mexicans and Mexican Americans is
perfectly legal.
But I see absolutely nothing wrong with that. Okay, but I think a lot of our viewers may not know that you can vote in a foreign election because, again, and you had to show ID
in Mexico, and it's happening in Europe, and it's happening with many countries, not only Mexico and the U.S. Last time I checked, Mexico is not invading the U.S., and we're not at war.
Invading the United States, and yet Mexican citizens live in this country, vote in Mexican elections, and then write books telling Americans like me how we should run our government when you clearly haven't haven't renounced your loyalty to a foreign government. Why should I take you seriously? With respect.
I happen to be also a U.S. citizen. And sometimes, and that's precisely the title of the book, sometimes I do feel like a stranger, because it seems, as you just pointed out, that for many Americans, I'm not American enough. And
Hold on. It's not about Mexico. It could be any country. But why should I take you seriously as an American if you are still tied to a country, despite the oath you took, apparently disingenuously, to renounce your ties to that country? You're weighing in a foreign election. In what sense are you fully American, sincerely?
Okay, well, just because of my arguments and just because I'm a U.S. citizen, just as you are. So it seems that I cannot complain about Donald Trump being the most anti-immigrant president since the 1960s.
I'm asking why I should take you seriously, and uh-huh. I'm just going to let our viewers decide their view on that. But let me ask you about the story that we just played. So here you have.